I want to show you how to create dynamic database connections. Let's start with a fresh Laravel project. I will install Laravel using composer create-project command. After installation, switch to your project directory and then run php artisan serve command. This will create local server, so project could be seen. In my case, it will be accessible on localhost using port 8000. Let's start by opening project in IDE or text editor. I will use Visual Studio Code. Open web routes file and add test route using get method so it could be easily accessible from browser. Test route will contain all necessary functionality for our tutorial. For default connection, I will use MySQL configuration as base, and then I will overwrite all necessary properties. And then new configuration will be stored in configuration array. Configuration could be selected using config function. Configuration key consists of file name, in this case database, and array keys, connections, and MySQL. Configuration could be seen by opening URL. There should be shown array with MySQL specific configuration. I need to quickly update database configuration in .env file. Default project database will be called test. Later I will create second database. Now I will open MySQL workbench and I will take a look into tables section. Everything looks fine, so let's go to next step. Let's create second database. Just for simplicity, I will call it second schema. Now let's work on to database switching. First, we need to select our default MySQL configuration and assign it to variable. In my case, I will change only database name. Database could be accessed using database key. New connection could be stored in configuration array by calling config function where we can pass array, and this array should contain key. This key should be unique and new configuration as value. Call connection method on schema and provide new connection name. After that, I will execute this code by refreshing test URL. Let's check if posts table exists in second database. Additionally, I will show you how to change connections for queries. Let's try insert data into posts table, which is located into test database. Let's verify that posts table for second connection was not populated with data, and our default connection posts database was populated with data. To change connection, we need to call connection method on DB facade. And for last time, we need to check database if data was populated properly.